My name's Dave Graham. I'm from Maine. I'm a rock climber, among other things. I like to travel in Europe a lot and live here. Europe felt special to me. It was the first real cultural change I experienced, and it kind of got sucked into it all. So from the year 2000 onwards, I spent as much time as I could legally in Europe. There's a lot of things that I would never have learned or experienced if I hadn't become a pro climber when I did.
No!
Notably, I would never have seen very many places in the world, nor would I have learned to speak languages so that I could interact with more people. I kind of think rock climbing has been the biggest tool I could have discovered as a person to learn about myself and the world. And then the other stuff is all from inside the mine, like this deeper yellow, kind of green colored. So, I only went in the mine once, but I think it was dangerous.
Well, I was just texting with my mom the other day, and I was like, hey, what you up to? And she's like, I don't know, I'm bored, it's cold in Maine. I said, you should just fly out to Spain, it's dope. She sent me a message, she said, you know, I'd like to come to Spain. I said, game on, let's do it. And she bought her flights and then she flew out here.
Yeah, it's very nice for me to see exactly, you know, what's going on and how his life is. So it looks pretty good to me.
It's hard for me. My family isn't really into climbing, so it's not like I get to share that with them. So it's really fun to share with them my world.
I try and learn from all the climbers, you know.
Just sent the boulder problem, no problem.
Yeah, I did it all by myself.
It's been a big challenge for me to stick around Maine a lot. And since I'm super global and travel, I'm like kind of nomadic, it's not easy to be back at home. It's not natural for me to return there in a way.
Oh, that's good. That's a good
one. I wish we got to see each other more, but it's really nice she comes and visits me.
We're here.
Yeah.
We're doing it.
Mm-hmm. Dude, you're soloing.
I'm soloing.
And your mom's watching. That's f***ed up.
I came out here for a lot of reasons, primarily just to do something new for myself because I've been in the same cycle and travel and life for a long time, and I've always done the same things for so many seasons in a row. And
yes, nice, Dave. Come
nice.
On.
Nice.
Come on.
This time my philosophy was just to start a year off with no pressure and to go on a trip without any goals and actually look at it as part of a bigger puzzle.
Come on.
Come on, babe.
Yes, yes, come on. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Nice. Sick. There you go.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, La Rambla, I was here when Ramonette did it first. I belayed Chris on the second ascent. I tried it when he did that. It kicked my ass super bad. I was terrified of it. The crack was really intimidating. I failed miserably in the crux up high. No chance, you know? Fast forward to now, 2018. Rambla feels awesome. I got here, I had zero endurance. I was just bouldering, and I started trying from the bottom. Second try from the bottom, I fell in the crux. And now let's say it's 8 tries later, I've fallen in the crux 6 times. Feels super close, but weather's been really tough. I really need these sport climbing trips because I don't put pressure on myself when I go sport climbing anymore. I spend so much time bouldering that's so much my primary focus in climbing that I only feel stress and pressure when I'm trying to accomplish projects I've been working on for 5 to 10 years or something. And I feel like I can come to Spain and sport climb and it's the contrary experience. I don't have pressure on myself because it's not my element right now and I can learn again. So it's not just about being a better boulder or being a better sport climber, it's about being a better climber. This has been one of the most encouraging trips I've taken in a really long time because it proves that the last 6 years of bouldering paid off. I feel a lot more capable and inspired to push myself.